My name is Jamie Littlejohn. I farm under the name of Littlejohn Farms. We're located south of Wallacetown, right on Lake Erie. We own about a mile and a half or a little better of the lake frontage. My grandfather purchased this farm in 1914. We have 10.6 acres enrolled in ALUS right now. We started in 2019, I think it was, with about 5.5 acres. I think agriculture as a group are possibly much more proactive than we've ever been. We were always interested in the proper management techniques, the health of everything, whether it's the land, the water, species, different species, special species. We see it every day. We can smell the lake, so we know when it's not healthy, but it's important to us. We like the lake. When I was a kid, that was our pool, every day, all day long.
Lake Erie, which is obviously the smallest of the Great Lakes, is probably one of the most productive, whether it's commercial fishing to tourism, but also to supporting a large agriculture, agri-food industry on both sides of the Canada-US border. But we know that there can be problems. In the 70s, we were tackling a nutrient problem because of phosphorus. Today, we're tackling a nutrient problem because of different issues, and we need to connect and collaborate across sectors and borders to make sure that we're addressing this nutrient issue head on. Governments on both sides of the border have set big targets, 40% reduction of nutrients in Lake Erie. But in order for us to really meet those targets, we need to see a different kind of collaboration. The real action needs to take place on a farm. And when I think about great programs that can be adopted, I think of the programs that ALUS is running, the work that farmers can do on their farm, whether it's buffer strips that enhance biodiversity, create nature and new habitats, create places for pollinators, and really use marginalized lands in different ways and get compensated for that land. To work to protect streams and fresh water. These streams are ultimately going into Lake Erie.
ALUS has received support from the RBC Foundation as part of the Tech for Nature grant program, which will allow ALUS to harness cutting-edge technology to deliver on-the-ground solutions for Lake Erie. The ALUS Lake Erie Test Transfer Project will deploy a predictive ecosystem service model to three Lake Erie subwatersheds, Kettle Creek, Catfish Creek, and Big Otter Creek, to evaluate and prioritize ALUS stewardship projects with the potential to deliver the greatest environmental benefits for the community, the Great Lakes region, and the Lake Erie Basin.
The IMWEB's model is a watershed model that's representing landscape processes and simulating the impacts of landscape changes, such as water quantity, water quality, and other indicators. Farmers and the ranchers are frontline environmental stewards. The IMWEB's information can help them to understand what the impacts can make so that they can make the best choice about implementing those projects to protect the water, the environment, and the communities. We're able to simulate the landscape processes and able to simulate the water and the pollutants and the water flow from the land to the stream and to Great Lakes. The IMWEB's model is able to support the collaborative action of farmers, ALUS, and other kinds of agencies in protecting the Great Lakes downstream.
Projects like the one that we're talking about today that brings so many different kinds of data together, socioeconomic, environmental, that brings land use data together, and is able to use smart technology to understand that information, to gather insights from that information in order to make better land use planning decisions, to make better farming decisions. That's the way of the future.